That is fall dessert recipe number two. Pumpkin cheesecake dip. It's really good. A good dessert or appetizer idea. Mm-hmm. Bring it back. I want some too.
Oh, my bad.
That I saw on YouTube is real simple and real quick and easy if you're not a baker like me, because I'm not, but I saw this recipe and I thought it would be good. So this is recipe one out of three that we're going to be making for our fall dessert video. So all you need is apple pie filling. Got this from Aldi, and then you just need cinnamon rolls. This came from Aldi as well. So I'm using a what you call this casserole dish. That's what it is. And I'm just gonna spray it with the butter spray. And then I'm gonna go ahead and open these up and cut them up into small pieces and then put them in the casserole dish. And then you just put it in the oven. She put hers in the oven for 375, I mean for 20 minutes at 375. So we're gonna go ahead and put this in there and then get started on the next one. Just sprinkle a little more a little more cinnamon on there. Since the apples look a little plain. And now I'm just gonna use that frosting that comes with the cinnamon rolls and just drizzle it all over. I was trying to do this a little bit better, but either way, it's gonna melt in there. So it's all right. But you like to make noise when it's time to be quiet. All right, guys, so this is the apple cobbler. I went ahead and plated it up with some ice cream so they can try it. This is what it looks like.
Looks shiny.
Go ahead. And that's Michael in the background. What you think?
I think the flavors really blending well together. Hold on, let me get a little apple. I'm really not an apple pie and ice cream type person, but this one I do like though. Tastes good.
Yeah, I think it tastes good too. Like he said, I'm not really an apple pie person either, or apple cobbler person, but this is pretty good, and it was something quick. So if you ain't trying to make an apple pie or trying to make an apple cobbler from scratch, this probably be your next best thing. So yeah, this is recipe number 2, and I'm only gonna use half of this because it's just us, and like I said, I know we're not gonna eat all this stuff. So I did use about half of the pumpkin. And then I got the whipped cream cheese. Her recipe, she used the regular, but I got whipped because I don't have a hand mixer. Because she used a hand mixer to mix hers up. I don't have a hand mixer, so I felt like it would be easier for me to mix it with a spoon if I got whipped cream cheese instead. So she used a whole 8-ounce block. A whole 8-ounce block. And this is an 8-ounce container, but again, I'm just using half of everything. And I didn't say the name, but the name of this is pumpkin cheesecake dip. And so she also used like a whole container of the Cool Whip or whip topping, because I got mine from Aldi. So again, I'm just using half of everything. Then she used some pumpkin pie spice. She used cinnamon as well. And brown sugar, so I'm just gonna get some out of here. And this is what it looks like, so I'm just gonna go ahead and mix it all together. And that's all she used, guys. This is what it's looking like. I'm going to taste it. Tastes pretty good. Wash my hands, because yes, wash your hands. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna add a little more cinnamon and pumpkin spice and a little more brown sugar, and then I think it'll be perfect. I think this would be a good little snack, to eat on from time to time. Keep it cool in the fridge. So I think that should do it. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in a bowl. And this recipe, of course, this is what the graham crackers is for. She used apple slices, and I was gonna get apple slices, and then I did an Instacart order and Abby didn't have them, so I should have got them while I was in Walmart, but I didn't. So, but she said that it would probably be good with graham crackers, which when she was doing it, I was like, yeah, this will probably be good with graham crackers. So I'm using graham crackers, but you can use any cracker or fruit or whatever you want to use with this dip, because I think it's going to be really good. Bae and Michael are playing in the background. That's what Michael's doing, that screaming. But yeah, so let me go ahead and plate this up and then I'll be back.
What is this that we have here?
It is pumpkin cheesecake dip.
Dip.
Yeah, it's dip. And I got some graham crackers to go with it.
Okay.
Light and fluffy.
It's sweet. You can really taste the pumpkin. I'm gonna get a fresh cracker. It's really good too, Black.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, guys, that is fall dessert recipe number 2. Pumpkin cheesecake dip. It's really good. A good dessert or appetizer idea. Bring it back. I want some too.
Oh, my bad.
All right, guys, so now we are doing recipe number 3. And this one is like a pumpkin pie twist, basically. So, don't need that many ingredients like I just showed y'all. So, I am going to go ahead and put the pumpkin in there. Then, drizzle in some maple syrup. This is the maple syrup that I have. From Aldi, y'all know I use this and it's really good. So I'm gonna drizzle some of that. I do not have all the measurements, guys, as I never do. So yeah, just do what you feel. Adding in some pumpkin pie spice. And then a little bit of brown sugar. And that's all you need to mix in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and mix this all up real quick and then go to the next step. And so I went ahead and mixed it up, and that's what it looks like. I'm gonna add a little more pumpkin pie spice too. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and mix this up, and then I'll come back and show you how to put it on the crescent rolls. All right, so I went ahead and got my pan out. I'm gonna go ahead and spray it down a little bit. Then I'm gonna open up the crescent rolls.
You saw us, aren't
I? Mm-mm. So this is what mine looks like. I set mine out a little too long while I was baking, and I should have had them in the fridge, but this is what they look like. It's not perfect, but do what you can do, girl. So now basically what you do is that mixture that you have, you're just going to put it on one side. Then you gotta take the other side and put it on top. Top. That's right, buddy. Little boy. Again, not perfect, but I should have had mine in the refrigerator. I'm gonna get you. Then you're supposed to, she had a pizza cutter, and I keep forgetting to get one. So you're supposed to cut them in even little pieces. So. This is gonna be much harder with the knife, but we shall see. And once you cut all of them, I haven't cut all mine yet, but what you're gonna be doing is basically twisting it. And it's supposed to look like a little spiral. And then you're gonna lay them on there. So, and she said this part was the hard part, and it is, especially with mine not being, cold and being kind of warm, so make sure you keep your crescent rolls in there, both in the fridge, until you get ready, because I should have did that. All right, guys, so yeah, so I'm just going to give y'all some tips. Number one, keep your crescent rolls in the fridge for as long as you can before you do this, because it is definitely very hard trying to put the crescent rolls together at first while they're kind of warm. And it's even harder to try to twist them with that pumpkin puree stuff in the middle. So tip number one, keep them in the fridge as long as you can. Tip number two, don't use that much pumpkin filling because it gets everywhere. I'm gonna show y'all what mine look like because they look a mess. Don't use but a little bit of that. And so, tip number three, get you a pizza cutter, because cutting this with a knife and while it was warm, miss. So yeah, those are my tips. But anyway, here's what mine look like. Like I said, you're supposed to be twisting them, so they're supposed to have like a little spiral in them. So anyway, what she did after she finished putting them in, she just put some butter on there and then put some like a cinnamon sugar mix. So this is cinnamon, sugar, and pumpkin pie spice in this. So again, like I said, don't judge me and don't mind how mine look. And I can't find my little small brush, so I'm just using Bae's grill brush. But yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead and put some butter on these. I think this one right here that I'm doing now is my favorite twist, but we'll see how they come out. But either way, y'all know, if you're not doing this for like a party or something, you're just doing this at home, it don't really matter how it looks. It's all about how it tastes. And again, this is my first time trying these. Now I will perfect them and make them for a party or something, possibly. But I just want to try these for y'all. So that is that. And so here is my cinnamon sugar mix. So I'm just gonna sprinkle some on each one. You can have much you want on there. All right, guys, so that's it. All you do now is just put them in the oven, 375, she said, for about 8 to 10 minutes. So that's what I'm gonna do, put a little more sugar. Put them in there for about 8 to 10 minutes, and then I'll be back to show y'all how they look in the end. All right, guys, so this is the third and final dessert recipe, and these are the twists. This is how they came out. I think this twist is probably my favorite. No, this one is probably my favorite one. So that's how they should look similar to. But we're gonna go ahead and give these a taste.
It pulled me something in the middle.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. It is, it's pumpkin in the middle, but I just taste the crescent roll.
Yeah, I don't taste the pumpkin.
Yeah.
I mean, I taste as far as texture, but not taste as far as taste.
And I only put, I put actually too much to twist it, but I don't know. But they did have, when they tried theirs, they put Cool Whip. I'll pop by you. They put Cool Whip on theirs, but what I think I'm gonna do is use that dip that we made and just dip it in that. No, you don't like it? Let me see. Yeah, they don't go together. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, it's straight, but, I don't really get pumpkin.
Mm-mm. But the cinnamon sugar tastes good.
Yeah, cinnamon sugar good on
nice
there.
Nice little snap.
So yeah, they're not bad, but I don't think it's giving what it's supposed to want give. Some? Want some, bud?
Want some? No. But you sure you don't want that?
No.
Okay.
Told y'all he picking. But yeah, guys, so that completes the video. Of the three fall desserts, I will have to say, out of the three, the pumpkin cheesecake dip is my favorite, because it was really light, fluffy, and a good little dessert or appetizer. So thank y'all for watching, and let me know in the comments if you try any one of these recipes, and let me know how yours turns out as well. Also, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share this video. And also, if you haven't watched all of my Vlogtober videos, make sure you go back and watch them. We are in the last week of Vlogtober, and this has been fun. So if you haven't caught up on all of them, make sure you go back and watch those as well. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.